I also had an email come through from a customer. She said her pool's gone green because she had a leak on the pump. So because of the leak on the pump, she turned it off, and that's why the pool's gone green. She couldn't get hold of the regular pool guy that she normally uses, so I said I'll pop down and have a look. Basically, there was a leak on the top of the pump here. I just took it off. Had a bit of grit and stuff on the O-ring, so I cleaned that off, put some grease on the O-ring, and then put it back on, and it stopped leaking. So just got the pump running again. I'm now going to start on the pool, and also she wants the hot tub cleaned out, so better get cracking on that. So the hot tub's going to get cleaned out, but that's going to stay empty. She's not using it. Pretty grim. Got some water boatmen swimming around. What I'm going to do as usual then is brush the whole pool, net out anything that's gone in there, get some shock in there, make sure the pH and everything's all good, and then it'll be just waiting for it to clear up. pH is very high, no chlorine obviously, so I'm gonna have to get some pH minus in there to lower that. So with the pH being quite high, it's gonna make the surface feel quite rough, and it's gonna scale up tiles and stuff, so not good, and it could be quite irritating for the skin as well. Next up then, sodium hypo. I think there's around 10 litres in here. It's a half full, it's a 20 litre drum. Now what I need to do now is brush the whole pool. Disturbing all the algae off the surfaces, the bottom, the sides, water line, and then leave it filtering. Tablet that's just been shaped by the flow of water. Now that the pool is, well, not done, but like that's as much as I can do on there today. I'm gonna move on to the hot tub. Get the jet wash out, submersible pump, get all the water out, rinse it out, and then leave it empty. Submersible puddle pump, which is great because it helps pump the water down really low, so then it's less hoovering for me to do. Little bit of surface cleaner to clean up the shell. And last little bits of stains off.
Looking a lot better then, but like I say, the customer wants to keep it empty. That's just a little crack in the shell. Maybe she wants to leave it until springtime. But anyway, I'm just going to pack away, clear off the copings, the slabs where I've made a mess, and then I'll just wait to hear back from the customer when the pool's clear, and I'll come back and hoover that to waste. All to get a settlement on the top step, so I don't think it'll be too long. Maybe these copings need a jet wash too. Maybe we'll get that done on our next visit.
So a couple of days later then, while the pool looks nice and blue, it's still not crystal clear like it should be. So I'm here to do the sand change today. Doesn't look too bad, it does smell quite a bit though. Thank you. filter all cleaned out then. The laterals look all good, nothing loose. So I'm gonna start getting new sand in. Back over here then after a few days of the pool filtering with the new sand, and we're 100% clear. A little bit messy, so what I'm going to do is get the vac equipment out and start hoovering, and then we'll be about done. Customer's been out keeping leaves out of the pool, but it's that time of the year, they fill up pretty quickly. Thank you. that's job done. Pool gone from green to cloudy, sand changed, nice and clear. Hot tub's also done, that's covered up with the end of an old shed. The customer is going to get a new cover for it, and then also he's going to get another, well, a new winter cover for the pool. Save all the mess going in over winter. But yeah, job done.
What are you waiting for the pool work?